Everyone, if you want to take a bunch of steps forward, please.
Yeah.
And invade our space.
Unless you're from Somerville and you stink.
No, please turn one light on. Please.
Hey, Joey, can you put the lights back on?
He's a smart kid.
Yeah, true. That's Dan and I'm AJ. We're hands on board from Rhode Island.
Yeah! Yeah!
That's an awesome shirt.
Things have been weird for a lot of people lately. And that brings a lot of weird things back to me because it seems like I've escaped the weirdness due to my day-to-day routine. And it seems like we all know someone's missing, and we all wish that person was here. And I know that person would be over to the left so I could look at him after I made a stupid joke. And if I make any stupid jokes, I'll look that way. About it, but I think we're all here for each other, if you know what I'm talking about. If you don't, sorry, I'm fucking weird. We got lyric sheets going around.
Pass them around. This is definitely for our friends, of which we have a high concentration of in Boston, so this is probably all you hear.
I'm sorry.
song's called A Bronx Tale.
Coffins and Trillion Barnacle Labs, and if you want directions and stuff like that, or if you're interested, we have flyers with us, and we have a couple more shows in the next couple of months happening at our house, so if you want to come down, that'd be cool. And we have the last official 8 records of our 7-inch before the repressing, so if you want one, just come talk to us afterwards. This song is called BSM.
You can't hear us say that. I think you'd be surprised.
To celebrate the death of Christ, but to, as an excuse to go visit my parents on Easter Sunday or whatever. And my parents are both from South America, and we have a lot of relatives that have come over. And I have a total of 15 cousins on my dad's side. And so they all came over for like family reunion shit or whatever. And we have like my youngest cousin's like 2 or 3, and the oldest one's 27, so we're all over the place. And I think with the exception of one aunt or uncle, every brother and sister my dad has married someone else who's Colombian. So they're all Hispanic, Spanish-speaking families. And it was kind of sad because I was there, and I have these two cousins that are like 9 and 12 or something like that. And like my family would speak to them in Spanish, and they'd respond in English. And everyone was like kind of trying to get them to talk and stuff like that, and they were super shy. And it just kind of, it's kind of shitty in a way because my parents stressed for my brother and I the importance of speaking Spanish at home and making sure that we had with us and instilled in us a part of their culture as well as a part of the culture that we grew up in. And so, I don't know, this next song is actually written in Spanish, and it's kind of exciting for me for a lot of reasons, like, because in a weird way I kind of felt maybe the way my cousins do about writing this, like, do I have a place at a punk show to sing a song in Spanish? Like, would it be weird if I say, hey AJ, I want to sing a song in Spanish, or whatever, like, as stupid as some of these thoughts may sound, they're like all going through my head or whatever. And it's about the importance of, you know, bringing up in places like this and places everywhere, at my fucking family reunion, anywhere, at the punk show, the importance of race and the role it plays in our lives. And so, I don't know, I hope to encourage everyone to do that, regardless of what race you are or whatever. And thanks again for watching. Thanks to Joey and to Rich and everyone else involved in setting this up. And thanks to all our friends for coming. And if you want to come up and introduce yourself and talk to us afterwards, we totally fucking encourage that. Don't be shy and stuff like that. So, this is it. We'll be right back.
I see you shaking your head over there. I can't do anything about this. These people.
I don't like that.
So we're called Yul Sid. We're from the Merrimack Valley, Massachusetts. There's one kid from the valley. Is there like delayed response time in this room? Oh, okay. Cool.
Merrimack Valley.
Is there like delayed response? Oh. So thank you guys for all for coming out to the show. It's nice to have a free show. It's nice to have an all ages show. It's always nice to play with Anton Boardman. Just an amazing band. And we're here to play for everyone in the room. Let's have no gender arrogance. Let's have no arrogance in the room at all. Let's have no cool kid attitude. So thanks a lot. This song is on our CD. It's called Single Sender. Thank you.
ocean, man.
Oh yeah, that one. We're watching Yulstead right now. We just saw Anton Boardman. Thank you. Brennan, how do you think the show's going?
I don't know. Has anybody seen where I parked my car?
Oh, very nice. Well, that wasn't very much of a response, but we're in the dark. We're here with Mitch Wimbish. I'm in night vision.
What that was pretty strong set for only, what was it, two songs?
No, that was one. Song.
No,
that was one.
Two songs.
Sorry.
That's enough for me. That's enough for my money.
Yeah, do it in the dark.
Ooh, I think they're coming back.
Thank you.
We're gonna play a new song.
It's just too dark, so it doesn't have to focus on.
Thank you.
See, the first two songs, they were going good enough, and then everything broke. Now I'm depressed about that. We've been a band for for 3 years now. We've never covered a song before. So this will be the first time we've ever done a cover before. And I think that the words that are in it that I'm able to decipher, that I've been able to decipher, kind of make sense of what's going on in everyone's lives lately. So this is a song called Dinner. It's by our friends in the band Ace. And there's a sing-along part, as I heard so many times. After three bell hits, everyone yells dinner. And then the middle of the song, everyone says, less paint, more green. So this is an Ace song.